are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Philadelphia Phillies. Phillies baseball starts right now. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, every team needs a pitcher like this one here. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. Career ERA just under 4. But one thing he does, he takes the ball every 5 days, throws strikes, and gives his team a chance to win every single time he goes out there. He'll be fun to watch in this one here today.
Now to the plate, John Torres. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. First pitch coming. Here it is. First of three here on a Friday night as the first pitch is in there for strike one. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've brought 5 of their last 8 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, these players got in their cars today to drive to the stadium focused on one thing. Not who was going to be the hero, just the fact that they needed a W and that one of their teammates, whether it's them or someone else, has to come up with a big knock.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. Up with it, Scott. And the throw is there to record the first down. Colton Wong will stand. Career line against Jared Eichhoff. He's a perfect 4-for-4. He also has 1 home run. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Harper has a read on it. And that's the second out of the inning.
Batting third, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Now the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Hey, they say solos won't kill us, but I gotta believe this guy's looking to do exactly that.
Swing and a miss on the slider. He's quickly behind, nothing and two. And set up behind the plate is Joe McDonald, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew in this one.
Hey, Joe McDonald, he's a tough guy to figure out sometimes, D-Ro. One inning, he'll be giving that inside corner. The next inning, he doesn't give much of that inside corner. His zone fluctuates a lot.
You know, Dan, you could see some definite confusion on the face of some hitters today. Questioning in the strike zone. One pitch is a strike on the outer half. The next time, it's a ball. Kind of a little cat and mouse with the umpire when you should be focused on the pitcher.
Yank the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Still 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. Now it'll be the Phillies' turn. No score. Number 62, a California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy's done a real good job on the year keeping the opponent's batting average down. Both righties and lefties coming into this one, hitting under 250 against this guy. He's been good all season long.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. They lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading off for Philly, the center fielder, Andrew McCutchen.
Here's the pitch. And hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. And fellas, we take a look at the Redbirds entering play here tonight. 4-2 over the last six games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty, for me today, the key to winning this ball game begins and ends on the mound. And it has to be early on the attack, getting 0-1. You can't allow these guys to get into count leverage and to hunt your fastball. There has to be execution down and away, up and in to keep these guys honest, and it has to start from pitch one.
All even now, 2-2. Fouled off.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. When you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Justin Turner comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. One out, nobody on. And a slider stays outside and he falls behind 2-0.
Going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. Strike two as the fastball is let go.
Got a pitch to the ballpark's dimensions right here. Love the execution of that pitch down in the zone. Got to keep the ball in the yard.
2-2.
Helpful.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Looking for back-to-back K's to start the game. To third. Fielded cleanly. And there's out number two. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Bryce Harper. Shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. Taken for a cold strike two.
One ball, two
you can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
Two out, nobody on. Fouled away. The 1-2 is taken for ball two.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Second inning ahead from Cincinnati, but first, here's Heidi Watney with more on the forecast.
Well, Matt, the weather forecasts I'm hearing down here point to a fairly significant threat of rain later in the ballgame. Of course, the grounds crew and umpires will work to get this one in without delay, but they also told me that they won't hesitate to halt the game to let the weather pass through if it's impacting the play on the field or, of course, putting the safety of the players at risk. For now, we'll have to wait and see how things develop.
Yeah, Heidi, thank you. And guys, certainly having a fresh bullpen ready for a game like this one will be an important step towards a victory.
You hope not, but you knew it potentially could happen. You kind of read the grounds crew. If they were running and scattering in the dugouts and running towards the tarp, you kind of prepared yourself that this one was going to get shut down at some point. But you got to stay focused. That pitcher doesn't care. He's trying to take food off the table.
Called strike at the knees. Evens the count at 1-1. That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now. Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. That's lifted the other way out to left. Benintendi is right there, and he's got it for out number one.
That is there. The shortstop, Paul DeYoung.
Stepping in for the Cardinals, Paul DeYoung. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. That evens it up, 1-1. Jumped the gun a bit on that swing. He's down 1-2. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Hit on the ground is short. Turner has it. And that's the second out. Bases are empty here with two gone, and into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Sometimes you just can't overthink it. If a guy can't hit a certain pitch in a certain quadrant, why would you throw him anything else? Case in point, this guy's cold zone is away, and this pitcher keeps attacking that exact spot.
No score here as we play inning number two. Swing and a miss got him reaching. And that ends the inning. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two, and we are tied 0-0. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Rhys Hoskins set to lead off the home half of the second. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And this pitch is right down the middle, strike one. And it's fouled away. A windup and the 0-2 pitch. Slap hard the opposite way. This will not elude the right fielder's grasp as he ranges over to handle it for the first out.
Batting fifth, the catcher, Reed. Got.
Coming to the plate now, Reed Scott, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
And he just misses inside with the fastball there. And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
Hey, no shame in that. Your eyes light up when that heater comes above the belt. That's so tough to lay off of.
Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher. A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. Bottom of the second here with no score. Takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
And he fouls this one off. Three, two, one more time. Fouled off. Here's the pitch. Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats. Foul. Pitch number 10 is the one that finally does it as he strikes out after a long battle here.
Hate to be Captain Obvious here, but he looks great to begin this start. That's already 3 Ks for him and the first 5 hitters. It'd be awesome to see him keep up this pace.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Sent on the ground out to second, taken in by Wong. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. We played two full, and we are tied 0-0. Here's Jackie Bradley now. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
It's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Now here's the pitch. And a curveball drops in there for strike one. And there's ball one.
1-1.
Bradley waits on the 1-1.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
To 2-2
now. Two strikes.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Just flat out frozen there. Nothing too deceptive about that four-seam fastball, so I think he wasn't expecting it at all.
Javier Báez.
Yadi Molina digging in now. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. He'll enter play here with an average just over 250. No home runs as of yet, 9 driven in. 0-1, the count to Molina. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at 1. And this pitch misses for a ball. 2-1 now to Molina. Curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
You know, when you haven't gotten a guy on base yet in the entire game, a three-ball count kind of feels like a little mini rally. Let's see if he can get on.
Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Called strike, and that'll run it full.
He's in complete command of his two-seamer right now. It's got great movement, great depth, running all over the place. This offense is going to have a tough time.
Sent in the air out to straightaway central. There to take it in is McCutcheon now for route number two.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, number 62.
So here now is the pitcher, number 62. He readies for his first plate appearance. The pitch. Here's a slider that's inside, 1-0.
Ball one, no strike.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. The pitch.
That's the ball.
Certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes.
Ball, that's
falling behind now, 3-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Cardinals have been held out of the hit column here. In there, and it's full 3-2.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle, center cut. Tough pitch to take.
Pops this one up. Scott over to his left. Trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Make it 9 straight here to start the ball game. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number 3. We are tied 0-0. And in steps Scott Kingery, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. Let's see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. First pitch coming. Here it is. Wind up and the 0-1. All over zone, a swing and a miss. Fastball straightens him up a bit. 1-2 now. And the pitch.
That's ball two. Two pitches now. The count is full.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2 in that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
Pitch home. Ripped on the ground to first. Taken in by Goldschmidt. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
The first baseman.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring in Gene Segura. Here's the pitch. Grounder to first, reined in, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Jared Eichhoff. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. 0-1.
Hey, either this hitter needs a cup of coffee or he was sitting off speed right there.
Fouled away. Here it comes. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Phillies down in order. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Stepping in and ready for another shot, John Torrance. Back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, man. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Now here's the pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for the ball. It's 1-0. Up top, it's 2-0.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Here's Colton Wong now, runner at first to start the inning. And Dan, when it comes to pitching in the rain, what changes?
I think the most difficult part, Matt, is the ball gets slippery. It's hard to keep your hands dry. And if you don't have a good feel on that grip, it's hard to control where you're going to throw the ball.
From the stretch. That misses for ball one.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
Now a throw over to first, and the runner will get back standing. In the air down the right field line and foul. Torres aboard here at first with nobody out. Lifted in the air out to center field. McCutcheon is under it. Makes the play, one away.
The batter. The first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
So one gone in the inning here with the runner at first. And that'll bring up the big bat of Paul Goldschmidt. From the stretch. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Here's the 1-0. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
You never want to fall behind as a pitcher, but doing it to a guy like this is even worse. He's got to bear down and execute for the rest of this at-bat, starting right now.
Pitch is popped up. Segura is there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Up next to the target, the third baseman. Gourmet.
The next to bat for St. Louis, Nolan Gorman. He flew out in his last at bat.
Almost, Matt. He almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this year.
0-1 the count. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Now a throw over.
No, he's safe.
He'll get back in safely. On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Oh, that's out.
Off for second. Pitch is high. The throw. Short hop, but he's out. Great play to pick the throw and slap the tag on him to end the inning. Another look at the throw down that results in a third out on the bases. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Now here it comes. Angels wind up. Here comes the 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. And that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Too far out in front that time. He can't keep it fair. 2-1. He can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Well, that's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Liner toward right center. That gets down, and the Phillies' first hit of the game is going to be for extra bases.
Well, back in the day, you would hope your leadoff man could work a walk, and they got an infield single, but not in today's game. Now they expect the leadoff hitter to have a little pop, just like this guy. Nice leadoff double.
Standing in now, Justin Turner. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. O'Neill arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field. But
digging in to try it again, Bryce Harper was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Ball one, no count.
Now here's a slider that can't quite get back to the outside corner. It's ball one. And this will be fouled away. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Here's one that misses now to the Philly right fielder. It's two balls and a strike. Swing, and he just fouls this one away. Here now the 2-2. High in the air out to center field. Bradley is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The first baseman, number 17, Reed Hoskins.
Two are gone in the Philly fourth, and that'll bring up Reese Hoskins. First offering on its way. In his career, Hoskins brings a batting average just a little over the 250 mark. He's set. The 0-1. And he lays off for ball one.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
In the dirt here, runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. In the dirt, no advance here, but it's 3-1 now. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Wow, you know he's not happy with that call. When it crossed the plate, it sure looked like a strike to me. Seemed to catch a ton of the plate. That's a tough way to give up a walk, but he's got to put it behind him now.
Stepping into the box, Reed Scott. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Here's the first pitch to him. And he pours this one in at the letters, 0-1.
Hey, be thankful the batter was sitting on something else. And that pitch might have went a long way. Those cement mixers, you get the barrel to them, they can be torched.
Behind 0-2 now. Two. Here it is. And a sinker there. Swung on and missed for out number three. Phillies leave a couple through four. Still tied. Nothing, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cardinals to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight to them. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi.
The third baseman.
Now batting, Nolan Gorman.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. If they want to get things going, how about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
In there, 0-1. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
Total agreement, Matt, in particular that pitcher's mound. You know, one of the things you have to really be careful, not just for the position players, but that mound gets awfully slippery and awfully wet when it becomes moist like it is right now. So the umpires are going to have to really pay attention to the conditions on the field.
A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. This is ball two. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. You can see there that they're currently residing in second place in the NL in that category. potential. That brings in the power hitting middle infielder Paul DeJong. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Count 1-0.
DeJong stands at an even 6 feet tall, a right-handed batter and thrower. He was a fourth round selection back in the 2015 MLB draft.
Hey, this middle round selection is still developing, but he's doing it at the big league level. And he has a lot of time to get his tool set ironed out.
1-1. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
In now, Tyler O'Neill. As he will take a look at a fastball in there. That strike zone expands just a little. It's 0-1. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. The wind up and the 0-1. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. That misses 1-2.
Hey, textbook waste pitch right there. Does he go elevated fastball again or something slow below the zone?
Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Scott finds it, but the throw is late, so the inning will continue after the strikeout pitch gets away.
Oh, man, he just muffed that throw. No other way to explain it. Looked like it caught him in the heel of the glove instead of the pocket, so he's going to get hit with a fielding error as a result.
So it's a runner at first with two gone. And in to hit next, it'll be the left-handed batter Jackie Bradley Jr. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Strike 0-2.
Two takes, now he's down 0-2. I'm not sure, but he may have been taking to give the guy first a chance to run.
Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Ran one in on him there as this is hit softly to third. And a close play at second, but the throw does beat him, and the side is retired. Cards lead one. Halfway home, still no score. From Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia, let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Ready now, Andrew Benintendi. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. 2-0, 1-0. And now the Cardinals get the bullpen working here. Both a lefty and a right-hander have stood up. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Benintendi swings the bat and throws from the left side and stands in at 5'10" tall. Was selected in the first round back in the 2015 MLB draft.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
2-1 on its way. Lying toward the alley in left center. Takes the turn and heads for second. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not what he wants them to be so far this year. You never know about that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going.
Digging in, Scott Kingery. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got a curve and wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Set, here it comes. It's swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And that's taken in near the line as the runner tags from second. The tag, and he is out at third base. It's a double play.
Third baseman number
digging in for his second at bat, Gene Segura. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch on its way.
Nope.
We'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now the 2-0. And swung on and missed strike one. There's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. Two out, nobody on. Checks his swing, but this will be strike two call.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well before. I'd be looking at him.
Ball four.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
That walk is going to feel a little extra frustrating for this pitcher. Not only do you never really want to walk the number eight hitter, but it's also going to let the pitcher hit this inning instead of forcing him to lead off the next one.
First offering on its way. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. Line drive to center field, and the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
And you talk about having a right here. This guy's working on it. Any mixed in and out. How would you like to be on the mound though? You've got to work against the opposition. You have to give it up anyway.
So now to the plate, Andrew McCutchen. Swings and grounds it to short, and that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home, and he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Well, it's been tough to score in this one so far. Fifth inning, that RBI base hit right there is a nice breakthrough.
Yeah, it's been a great pitcher's duel up until this point. They've been executing on the bump without question, but that RBI knock right there makes such a punch for later.
Justin Turner takes a look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Well, you don't need us to tell you, it's really starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Yeah, Matt, right now this doesn't look too good. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see the umpires come out and bring the ground crew out here. The infield around the mound and around the home plate area is really getting soaking wet, and I can't anticipate this going on very much longer.
This one. And he takes a big swing at that one as this one's lifted high in the air and deep out to left field. And that baby's gone. Phillies have opened things up now 4-0.
like he might just work out of that inning only giving up a single run. But it all comes crashing down on that mistake. Nothing like a three-run bomb to change the entire complexion of your day on the mound.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back, off-speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Through five innings, it's now 4-0 Philadelphia. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
Yadier Molina.
First offering on its way. And he fouls this one off. Oh, and one, the count to Molina. And this catches the inside corner. Good spot there. It's 0-2.
Man, this guy's really pitched well so far, attacking the strike zone, and he's really kept these hitters off balance.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Here he comes again. 1-2. Pops him up toward the left side of the infield. Here for it is Segura to make the play. One gone.
Now that is the pitcher, Matthew Lieberthal.
Jairo Munoz will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 34, Jairo Munoz.
Oh, fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Fastball is looked at for strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on. And when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
To the plate now, John Torres. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. It was a walk in his last trip. Wind up and the 0-1. This one's down to third. Throw in time and the side is retired. Down in order go the Cardinals. They're down 4-0. take over on the mound in relief.
Number 56.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins. He'll lead it off as we start the home sixth.
Three.
Here's the first pitch to him. And this is taken outside for ball one. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
Here he comes on 2-0. Takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
And that's in there for strike one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Behind 0-2 now. One out, nobody on. Struck him out again, his third punch out of the game.
It's been a rough night at the yard for him. That's three times he's gone down on strikes in this one. So they've really figured out how to attack this guy.
And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. The 1-0. He's looked at for the first strike. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Still 1-2. And the pitch. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back even now at 2-2.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
And he chased it in the dirt. Molina gathers. And the throw to first ends the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. But they hold a 4-0 lead. Last trip.
We're moving right along into this one as we head into the late innings. Listen, if you want to score, you got to have to bunch some hits together. They haven't been able to do that so far. So hopefully this leadoff guy, this will be the right guy at the right spot to get something going.
The windup and a 1-0 pitch. And it's a called strike to even the count of one.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger.
Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Line drive to center field, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So the inning's underway with the Cardinals getting their leadoff hitter on base. They finally break through for their first hit of the ball game, so the no-hit bid will end right here.
Yeah, Matty B, this is when you start thinking about that no-no. You get into the seventh inning, D-Row. As a pitcher, you start looking ahead to what might happen.
And that donut stares at you from an offensive standpoint as well. This guy's had his A game. You can't deny the fact that he's pitched a heck of a game. But from an offensive standpoint, you never stop grinding. You get a crooked number up on that play.
Comes set. Now the pitch. Oh, it's hit to third. Five, four, out, three, and they turn the double play.
It's hard to do anything with a pitch like that that's below the zone. And if you do anything with it, most of the time, this will be the result, a double play on a good pitch down in the zone.
Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Nolan Gorman. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. First pitch of the at-bat. Slow curveball at 74 in for a strike.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked a guy up with it.
In the air, down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Up and the 0-2 pitch, and he's got himself another one. He picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Ready for another shot now, Scott Kingery. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, man. They want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The wind up and the 0-1. Out on him, and that's a strikeout. Molina has it. Throw down to first, one away.
Now, you know, you made a real nice pitch when you bounce it in the dirt, and you still get the hitter to swing at it. That tells me that there's a lot of deception in that pitch right now.
Ready once again, Gene Segura. Offering on its way. And looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one. Bases are empty, one man out. Ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was laid on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Line towards center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Philadelphia.
Now to the plate, the pitch. pitcher, Jared Eichhoff. He's been great on the mound, so we'll see if he can do something with the bat here as well. He's earned a chance to take this at bat.
Yeah, Matt, when a guy's throwing the ball as well as he has, it kind of forces the manager's hand to stay with him. He's been exciting to watch, and he's really had this crowd behind him the entire game.
Here's the first pitch to him. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Next for Philadelphia, the center fielder, Andrew.
The tour gone now in the Philadelphia seventh. And that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. First pitch coming, here it is. Yeah. Going to be lucky to make contact there as his curveball's hit fouled off to the left-hand side. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Popped up. Goldschmidt over to his right. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. One left for Philadelphia. They lead it 4-0. Into the box now, Paul DeJong. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
DeJong.
First delivery to him on the way.
Ball one, no right.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
The 1-0 home. Out in the bullpen, couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 2-1. Looked at for ball three.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning.
Well, when you've been out there as long as he has, you have to expect to lose a little precision in your location. He's up over 90 pitches now, so he might be starting to tire a little bit. Something to keep an eye on.
Into the box, Tyler O'Neill. He's hitless in the game, as is much of the rest of his team.
Strike this guy out.
Set and the pitch.
Nope.
And that's ball high one. For a ball, 1-0.
Count 1-0.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ballgame.
And that's in there for a strike, 1-1.
Two.
Time to be alert for signs of tiring here in the eighth. He's a pitch away from 100.
Man, I love this right now. He's given it everything he has, given this team depth, allowing the manager to make some serious matchups when it comes to going to the bullpen.
Boy, you nailed that, Hero. Now you can go to your go-to guys, the troubleshooters, the guy you want to bring into close games. Anytime a starter can get you through seven innings, the eighth inning, it's a bonus. A job well done so far. I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
Ball 2-2. Hit out towards second. Kingery's there. Turner for one. On the first, not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw.
It's really tough to double up a guy with the speed that he has. And he was hustling all the way on this ground ball. So they should be happy they at least got the guy out at second. It'll be interesting now to see if he tries to use that speed again and swipe a bag and get into scoring position.
From the belt, kicks and deals. And a called strike down in the zone, nothing and one.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because his first pitch strike ratio is still under 60%.
A ball and a strike now. Hard liner to center field. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
Well, we've mentioned the conditions aren't ideal with the rain coming down, and that can make every play a little bit of an adventure. You really have to concentrate, and he did there to haul it down.
Digging in now, Yadier Molina 0-for-2 for him to this point.
I mean, Yadi, when he first broke on the scene, was a defender first and foremost. You can't say that anymore. I mean, he's evolved into a really, really nice offensive player.
And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing and one.
That elevated fastball right there, that is the biggest change in the game today for me. When I first came up, a lot of guys working at Greg Maddux east to west.
Upset with the 0-1. Fly ball out toward left center field. McCutcheon will put this one away and the inning is over. One left for the Cardinals. They trail here 4-0. Digging in and looking for more, Justin Turner. And he'll start out the bottom of the 8th inning.
The last at bat, Benny, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. Didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Here's the first pitch to him.
0-1.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in 2 count and the pitch. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Back to the fastball, but it's upstairs. 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Well, 2 straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
From 0-2 to 3-2, what a great at bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
Now the payoff pitch home. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Around first, digging for 2. He'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one. I think we can say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
Into the box now, Bryce Harper could really use a knock here. 0-for-3 in the game so far. First pitch.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Ready with the 0-1.
Curveball
misses inside. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. the 2-1 home. A runner at second, nobody out. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Squared that one up just a little late. Next 3-2. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are first and second now with nobody out.
So next to the plate for the Phillies, Reese Hoskins.
He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Nope. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Well, he's really in trouble, and it's just getting worse and worse and worse. This guy needs to find the strike zone in the worst way.
And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Now 2-0 home.
Hey.
Great job of doubling up on the fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
Now the 2-1. None out, runners at first and second. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
This is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Well, you gotta love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball. If he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's gonna have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
Into the box now, Reed Scott, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 1-0 home.
Hey.
Swung on and
missed. It's 1-2.
The 1-2. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. As a look, now the pitch. And a strikeout here yet again. It's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the fourth time he struck out in this game alone. And that's not something you'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you can have.
Stepping in now, Andrew Benintendi. Oh, that one deflects off him. I think it got his arm. Great support from his infield, though, as that's the third out. Weird way to end the inning. Phillies leave a couple, so they're in front, 4-0. Victor Arano comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 64.
Cutler is going to pinch hit here to lead off the ninth. And with his club already well down, they'll just need to try and get on base here. Strike strike one to start the at bat. But a called strike, 0-2.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
Now here it comes.
He was looking for a swing and a missed breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all on the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one.
The 1-2.
At the ball.
He went with the off speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
2-2, here it is. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Hey, this has been an epic at bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
3-2 pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
And that at bat will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total, the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, John Torres. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
All you can ask as an offense is to try and get that tying run in the batter's box. And they've started out nicely right here. They've got two runners on. They're down four. Grand slam is still in play. Let's see if they continue this nice offensive approach.
Digging in once again, Colton Wong. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb. But hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden this thing feels doable.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Popped him up. Scott moving to his left. One out.
Up next to the Cardinals, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Hector Neris answers the call from the dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. Paul Goldschmidt will be his first assignment here as he'll face it with runners at first and second and one gone. Now the pitch. I couldn't lay off the pitch inside. It's 0-1.
They've done a real nice job keeping this guy into wraps in this one. No hits for him so far, and what stands out to me is they're going right after him. They're not pitching him like they're afraid he's going to do any damage.
nothing and two count, and the pitch. And this is fouled at the plate. Ready with another 0-2.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
The 1-2. And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. Swing and a liner. And this is going to wind up his extra bases, as that'll play one for sure and maybe a second. As he arrives at second without a play, as also on the play, a run comes across to score.
The third base.
Never say never in this game, folks. It's late and the clock is ticking, but that RBI double might start making believers out of the entire dugout. We'll see if they can build on it and maybe get back into this thing.
At plate, Nolan Gorman. He'll pop this one foul off to the left and out of play. Facing right-handed pitching so far in this season, Gorman carries a batting line a little over the 260 mark. He's set. Here's the 0-1.
These are the situations right here that make me miss wearing a uniform. The big spot, the cat and mouse of what's he going to throw. I'm down 1-2. Can I battle back? The pitcher's trying to put me away. This is what the game's all about.
Working for the punch out and the offering. And this is swung on and missed, so they come right after him, and it remains second and third, but with two away now.
On the mound, he's thinking, grab some pine, Rook. Listen, for almost everyone, the adjustment to hitting big league pitching is a big one. Some guys have success when they first get called up, but as soon as teams start figuring out how to get you out, that's when the learning process really starts.
So Paul DeJong digs in next. With two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. Count the pitch. Runners at second and third with two gone. Fouled away. A crowd in excess of 37,000 come to their feet. And this is in the air to right. And this should do it. He brings it in, and the Phillies have taken the opener here at home as this ball game is over.
Always nice to get the first game of the series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd. Seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
4-1 finish in this evening's game. The Philadelphia Phillies used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Jared Eichhoff earns the win, his second, allowing only a single hit across eight full innings. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.